Hey, church family. I wanted to take this opportunity to present you with another word of encouragement as we continue to prepare for the Great Reset. Now, you might be wondering, what's the Great Reset? Well, to sum it up, there are leaders all around the world using a motto, build back better. For example, a special advisor of the UN, Fabrizio Hochschild, he recently declared this. He said, we need a whole of society response to share information and research to address the damage to lives and livelihoods and to ensure we build back better. It was also last May when Boris Johnson declared, we owe it to future generations to build back better. And it was last July when Joe Biden declared, we have a great opportunity to build back and to build back better. Now, we might be wondering, well, who's plagiarizing whom? You know, is Joe Biden plagiarizing Boris? Is Boris plagiarizing Fabrizio? But before we start accusing anybody of plagiarizing, it's important for us to realize that the phrase building back better, or BBB for short, it actually became a popular catchphrase after the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami. It was at that point in time when leaders began to realize that the period of time after a disaster is an optimal time to make changes within a community. According to the Build Back Better website, the post-disaster reconstruction and recovery phase presents a unique opportunity to introduce new ideas, technologies, and methods to improve on pre-disaster conditions. In the light of this BBB plan, we shouldn't be surprised to learn that there are many globalist leaders who are preparing to build back better as they prepare for what's known as the Great Reset. For example, Klaus Schwab, he's the executive chairman of the World Economic Forum. He's described the Great Reset by declaring this. He says, to build back better, we must reinvent capitalism. Okay, Klaus, what do you mean by reinvent capitalism? Well, we don't have to leave it up to our imaginations, and we can be thankful that the World Economic Forum answers this question by assuring us that this includes more and more government regulations of businesses in order to fix the problems of capitalism. I also find it interesting that the author of this article, they use the word seize to describe the Great Reset. For example, this article informs us that it's vital that we seize this opportunity to correct the broken incentives and information flows at the heart of our current model of capitalism. Again, the author writes, if we don't seize this opportunity to build back better, to reset and reinvent rather than return to normal, systemic risks and vulnerabilities will continue to accumulate, making future shocks both more likely and more dangerous. Now, I get it. You know, the author is using the word seize in the sense of seizing an opportunity. And yet, in the context, I can't help but to think about the common goal of every Marxist, which is summed up as seizing the means of production. And so that word seize really catches my attention, especially in the context of building back better and the Great Reset. Now, you might be thinking, Bunjee, you know, you're just jumping to conspiratorial conclusions here. But now, before you just outright dismiss me as a crazed conspiracy theorist, let's consider another article, which is also found on the World Economic Forum website. This article is titled, Here's How Life Could Change in My City by the Year 2030. The author of this article sets out to describe their idea of the future utopia that they're hoping for. And this is how they begin the article. Welcome to the year 2030. Welcome to my city, or should I say our city. I don't own anything. I don't own a car. I don't own a house. I don't own any appliances or any clothes. Now think about that for a moment. If the citizens of this future utopia don't own anything, well then who does? Who are the owners? Who owns the vehicles? Who owns the businesses? Who owns the farms? Who owns the means of production in this utopia? Well, the government does. The government owns your car. The government owns your clothes. The government owns everything. Listen, this is nothing more than a utopian fantasy that convinces people to embrace Marxism. And listen, Marxism always results in the murder of dissenters. Now, don't get me wrong, because I'm all for living in a utopian society. I would love it if every day were like a Sunday. And yet, as we look at every society where Marxism has been put into practice, there's always starvation, there's always suffering, not to mention the slaughter of every insurgent. This is not a utopia. This is a nightmare. Please trust me when I tell you that the Great Reset, it's going to result in a global economy which is preparing the world for the rise of a dictator, namely the Antichrist. That's where this is all headed. And, the Bible already tells us exactly what's going to happen. There's going to be a global economy, and there's going to be a global government, and the Antichrist will rule over all of that. The only time that this world is ever going to end up in a utopian, a wonderful society that we could call a utopia, the only time that this is ever going to happen is when the Lord Jesus returns and establishes his kingdom here on earth. That's the utopia that I'm looking forward to. And that's the utopia that you ought to be looking forward to. And with that, I encourage every Christian, let's hasten the day of the Lord's return. And one way that we do this is by going out and leading the lost to the foot of the cross, where we can experience the great reset that occurs within our hearts. This great reset occurs as we repent and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. And if we'll simply embrace the grace of God by faith in Jesus Christ, he will build us back as better believers for his glory. Now, with this as the goal, I encourage every Christian, let's continue fighting the good fight of faith, all for the glory of God.